ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome once again to Beer Goggles Reviews. We're down here at the Hoxback Brewery, and we've got Miles Chesterman here. What is it, a head brewer?
Head brewer.
That doesn't mean he brews heads. It means he's kind of down here like...
We thought about it.
Coming up with all sorts of ideas. He's got one here, this is the Hogs IPA.
Hopping Hog IPA.
So we're going to have a little sniff and talk about it. Firstly, the sniffs on it are all very, very weird. Now, tell us what you've got going on, different hops and that going on in there.
What we did with this, we wanted we looked at boarding between the stronger American IPAs, but also the traditional English IPAs, the stronger, the darker. So what we tried to do with this, we went for a quite a high gravity beer, so something that will leave a lot of residual sweetness. We put some chocolate malt in there to give a bit of that licorice flavour on it as well. In regards to combination of hops, we used a combination of the Fuggles for bitterness and aroma. We used some Chinook.
So the Fuggles in aroma as well?
A bit in aroma as well. We used some Chinook. That's a bit of a dual purpose hop, even if you add it late in the boiling, it gives some bitterness and aroma.
Yeah.
Then we did some dry hopping in fermenter as well, and a fermentation. We had some Mountain
Hood. What was your dry hopping?
We used some Mountain Hood and we used some Cascade as well.
Lovely, yeah.
So what we've tried to do with it is, I think from a brewer's point of view, I think you find a lot of IPAs can be too dry, too bitter, not rounded.
Yep.
So what we've done is we've tried to do an IPA that is got some sweetness, got some body to it, get a hop aroma, but it's actually a well-balanced beer.
This is why I like you guys so much. It's certain things, what I keep having to go about, the IPAs and things like that, everyone thinks IPA has to be a fruit bowl all the time. It doesn't have to be. You can have a mixture of some English sort of flavours in there and some different New Worlds and American flavours and things like that. So let's have a little snort and snifter and see if we've got that. That's twisted first. Look at the twist, look, I've all over his boots. It's just lovely. It's got like the fruit aromas that you got are nice and delicate. The malts ain't lost. You know, they ain't like buried. I think good brewing sometimes, and I'm not blowing your trumpet because you're brewing in your ear and that, but good brewing sometimes is down to balancing the more delicate flavours and not just throwing citra at everything.
Yeah.
It seems every brewer now is throwing citra, Galaxy citra, Amarillo, everything, and you know.
It's one of those things, it may be my view, partially it's my view, is you can always bunk hops of beer. You'll have one of them, you'll take a sip, you'll have an aroma, you think, fantastic.
Yeah.
But after a quarter of a pint, do you want to drink the rest of the pint? For me, I don't. Yeah. So what I've tried to do is, what we've tried to do with this beer is make a beer, it's got the hop, it's got the sweetness, but if you want to go back, you want to have another one.
Yeah.
It's that sessionable beer. Yes, it's stronger ABV, but it's generous of flavour, aroma and colour, and that's what we want to do.
And also embrace new hops, embrace kind of different flavours, but at the same time don't lose identity, that is a British identity.
Yeah, you know,
which is where IPA came from.
Yeah.
So let's have a little drink of this. Cheers, bro.
Cheers.
That is a weird beer. You get the first mouthful and I'm going, okay, when's it eating? You know, it's, no disrespect, it's not eating you at first. And it's kind of, okay, I've got the mouthfeel, but there's not a lot going on. Suddenly, hey! Just as you swallow it, it all goes, whee! And there's a party in the park, you know.
Well, I think what you get is you get that sweetness, you get that licorice, then the hops come through
all
on the taste at the end. That's sort of what we wanted. It's not hot, and that's it. It's you've got, like I said, you've got that body, you've got that
and
sweetness.
It's a lovely dry finish, a lovely bitter finish.
Yeah.
And it's calling for more. Like you say, it's making you want more of it. It's just like, all the lot at once just attack you. It's like being gang raped by it, you know. It's the old lot.
I'm looking forward to coming out.
Yeah, in a nice way, you know. But yeah, it's just gang molested by a beer, and it's really in a nice way. I'm going to have another little go. I'll see if I can bring a few flavours out. grapefruits, you've got little hints of blood oranges, you've got little floral notes, you've got peppery little notes right on here. Right on the tip of the tongue, little peppery notes.
You get that licorice.
Yeah, little fennel notes, yeah. Licoricey notes, things like that. Just cracked, almost like you've just chewed a little seed of fennel. Ooh, like that, you know. And just comes right on the tip of the tongue, little spicy notes. Tiny little hints of cloves almost that you get in some wheat beers.
Yeah.
You
know. Yeah.
But all put together in and salty almost as well.
Yeah.
Strangely.
Yeah.
Little salty notes, but really nicely. All put together in a glorious beer, that is lovely. Once again, fantastic job.
Glad you like it.
Yeah. And once again, the Oxbeck boys have done it again. Fantastic.
Cheers.
Cheers, bro.
Have you enjoyed it?
There's got to be a bottoms up. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh. See us in the next one.
Cheers.
Don't be late.
Bye.
We'll start with that.
Brilliant. Enjoy that.
Brilliant stuff.